What the fuck is going on, my niggas? And for the females that watch me, how you doing, young women? You already know what I'm saying. So let's get to it. You already know what it is. It's your boy Manny. Today we're gonna be dropping another video talking about why you should stay off social media. Now, if you've been watching me for a while already, you already know why it's good to stay off social media. So clicking this video is just probably another video that you probably already heard. But I feel like hearing my perspective on things is kind of better or more aggressive. Or I don't know. I don't really, you know, but I think it'd be good to hear my side of things. Or at least I think you guys would like to hear what the fuck I got to say. Anyway, why you should stay off social media, especially like at a time like this. Now, if you guys haven't noticed, there has been a trending topic second after second after second after second. And I don't even got to get into the in-depths of each situation that I'm talking about, whether that's, you know, if we start off from start, Kobe dying, you know, race wars, you know, wars with other foreign countries, police brutality, and then the whole George Floyd situation with him dying and his neck being stomped on, even though that was, if you guys know, he was a Freemason, I'm gonna say that. George Floyd was a Freemason, I'm gonna leave that there, and if you guys... Okay, so basically what I want to talk to you guys about today is stay the fuck off social media. Stay off Instagram, stay off Facebook, stay off Twitter, stay off anything that is promoting distractions. Like, bro, I cannot go on Instagram and scroll down for 5 fucking seconds without staying on one fucking topic or one video that I seen, because there's always some bullshit that's happening after the next scroll. And one thing that I've been peeping is this WAP shit trending a lot. Like, if y'all know about Cardi B or any of these female celebrities that promote sexual activity in about 80% of their music and 80% of their music videos, these are mainly what's been forcibly in our face for the past 2 fucking months, 3 months, the past start of 2020. They have been constantly sexualizing these apps and these platforms to fucking break down and kill these fucking children's brains into thinking that they have to be like Cardi B, or if not her, portray her personality, such as twerk, wear short clothes, wear clothes that your parents don't even want you wearing, all this other goofy shit. And a lot of this shit is because pedophilia is becoming higher and higher and higher and higher by the second. And they're damn near trying to make pedophilia legal. If you guys don't even know, you don't even get charged for sexual assault to a minor if you're in California and you're over the age of 21 or some shit. Go look it up. It's online. People have been going crazy about it. But basically what I'm saying is that they're trying to desensitize everybody to believe that pedophilia is okay. They're sexualizing everything on these platforms. They're throwing all this shit in y'all kids' faces when y'all don't even know, and y'all at work, yo kid. It's children literally making videos of them dancing to WAP. But not even that, they don't even live the WAP life. Like, they're just doing it to fit the fuck in. Like, I came across a video and the dude said, shout out to I Am Lucid, but I don't know why I said dude, but yeah, him. He was saying that he went outside and he seen some females that was under the age of probably like 15 sneak outside, don't even look like they participate in anything that has to do with dancing or shaking ass. They literally just been on TikTok, and since they seen it trending on TikTok, they told themselves that we should go outside and make a TikTok. Not only that, they weren't even supposed to be outside. They sneaked out. These little hoes snuck out, went to the playground, took off all their fucking clothes, even though it was like below 40, like 50 outside in Detroit, Michigan. I literally remember this story. And they made a fucking 10-second, 30-second video until they got it correct. And then they went in the house. Now, you're like, okay, well, that's children. That's true. But the problem is, look how much time they fucking wasted for nothing. What the fuck did they gain from that? What? Recognition? Likes? Comments, my nigga? Like, what the fuck did they gain from that? So my point is that we are dealing with the hardest fight that we have ever dealt with mentally in this generation that there's ever been seen. They are trying their hardest. Their hardest to distract you with all this bullshit. This video doesn't even have to do with no in-depth science, the brain, and all this other shit, but it does. So basically what I'm saying right now is, and I'm gonna keep saying this because I feel like people don't take this to consideration or even listen to it. When you're constantly on your phone and when you're constantly training yourself to get up in the morning and to, when you first thing wake up, you go to fucking TikTok to go watch videos, you are not only making that decision, you are automatically placing that in your brain to become something that's gonna become natural. So you are destroying your brain cells that you should be using for what you want to do, because now your brain is like, okay, the only way I believe I get release of dopamine is when I go on TikTok. And so you see how that all ties up? The problem is everything you guys do is dopamine. Everything is dopamine. And that's what they're doing. They're manipulating your dopamines in your brain to self-destruct yourself. They're making you self-destruct yourself so you can't blame it on them. Because let's be real, you can put down your phone, you can delete the apps, but you don't want to. Why? Because the only way you feel like you can express yourself the best and the most authentic is through a fucking app. When nobody even gives a fuck about you through that app or gives a fuck about what you're really going through if they were to ask. Like, bro, so this video was just to basically inform y'all that all of this shit is a distraction to keep y'all away from the political world and what's really going on in foreign countries. How about this? In China and North Korea, Kim Jong-un is forcing all North Koreans to give up their cats and dogs for food, meat, and restaurants. Y'all didn't know that though, right? Y'all didn't know that though, right? Y'all didn't know that there's floods and floods and floods of acres of farms being destroyed in China, right? When about 60% of our crops and corns come from China, right? Y'all don't know that though, right? Y'all don't. Now, as other YouTubers, aka like Soluminati, you know, that talks about this, Spiritual Soul, my bad. There's other YouTubers like NLE Choppa that talk about this, but they're not, you know what I'm saying? They're not, you know what I'm saying? But they are. Like NLE Choppa, he's just now getting into the spiritual awakening, so he kind of owns some, he more into the fantasy side of things instead of just trying to face reality, instead of trying to do all that, realize that this is actually like a political fight and that we need to take back the power that we already had when we were on this fucking land. So basically what they're trying to do is make us go against each other without even knowing. Literally without even knowing. Without even knowing. Behind our back. All this shit is happening. This Karen meme, this Karen trend, all these Karen hashtags, these memes are psychotronic warfare, manipulative weapons used against you in order so you won't even think for yourself or wonder what the fuck is really going on. 80% of y'all, if y'all put down everything that y'all do, if y'all put down y'all phones, whatever the fuck y'all do involves technology, if you were to put down your phone, right, you wouldn't know what the fuck to do. You wouldn't know what the fuck to think. You wouldn't know shit because all you know is what you fucking pick up and what's been shown to you on this fucking screen. You don't even know how to think for yourself. If I turn my phone off, the first thing I would think about is nature, my chakras, my energy, my concern for my mental health, all type of shit. 80% of y'all motherfuckers, if y'all put y'all fucking phone down, y'all niggas gonna go blank. Y'all niggas are going to go fucking blank. Why? Because what the fuck are you doing when you're scrolling? You're just scrolling. You're not thinking. You're not processing. You're not dissecting. You're not doing shit. You're not working on yourself. You're working for them, my nigga. So when you're literally just scrolling, people complain about, oh, the white people have power, blah, 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 blah. But you're giving them more power by sitting on your fucking phone all day, buddy. And it's okay to be on your phone, but do some shit that's productive while you're on your fucking phone. Read some shit, my nigga. It ain't hard to either watch my video or go watch some nigga that talks what I talk about or go read a fucking book that explains what I'm trying to tell you. Like, so this video was an open world discussion instead of something specific. This was more as get your fucking life together, basically, is what I'm saying. Mentally before you do it physically, because your body's not going to be able to remotely act out as you want it to if you're not even okay mentally. So y'all take that as that. I'm gonna be uploading this bitch today. Love y'all. Simple. Y'all already know. Yeah, though, that's basically all I wanted to say. Do research on China. Do research on what the fuck is, bro, like, man, just, you know, don't even worry. If y'all really want to know what the fuck is going on, I literally, like I said, I have recent previous videos that talks about what's going on. Whether you're interested or not, if you want to know, go watch them. If you don't, I don't give a fuck. But it will help you and it will help the world. Like, there's no such thing as asking for change. There's making a change by choice. There's not asking, wishing, all that shit is out. There's no wish, there's no hope, there's no nothing. There's do it or it doesn't fucking happen. That's the attitude you need to have. Apply that to everything you fucking do. If you take away believing and hope and all that other shit and you just put your mindset as either I fucking do it or I won't get it, I promise to God, your hesitation for questioning or being in between like hard situations or trying to decide something will become more easier. Your life will become more easier if you apply the idea of I either do it or I don't get it. If you live by that, you will become successful. Be you. Don't be for them. Bye, my nigga. When I get emotional.